Hello guys, this is Ishwar Samarthy Prasad from Facts Editor channel, and today I have brought the part 3 of the history of pandemic and epidemics in India and in other countries series. In this video we are going to discuss about smallpox and the chickenpox. As they both have almost same properties, we will include these both topics in the same video. So without doing time waste, let's begin our episode. Now let's discuss about this hazardous disease. The name of this virus is smallpox. The cause of smallpox is variola virus. The smallpox is an extremely contagious disease which is caused by the deadly virus called variola virus. The variola virus has two forms, namely variola minor and variola major. Variola virus is a deadly virus being a member of the orthopox virus family. The structure of this virus reassembles that of brick ones, and the core of the virus is made up of a genetic material DNA which reassembles a dumbbell in shape. The DNA in the core comprises necessary proteins which are required to replicate like the host cells. The incubation period for this disease is about 17 days. I mentioned the meaning of incubation period in my another video titled The Vocabulary of Coronavirus, which is the episode 3 of the Corona Update. The incubation period is the time period between when the disease is infected and the disease symptoms come out, which later results in severe fever with the appearance of rashes on the face, legs, arms, hands, and etc. Guys, now let's discuss about the spread of smallpox. Smallpox is an airborne disease that spreads at a faster rate and is mainly caused by an infection of a deadly type of virus like variola. It transmits through the droplets released from the coughing, sneezing, and face-to-face contact with an infected person. Second, this infection is also transmitted by sharing drinks, exchange of body fluids, like blood, transfusion, and etc. Third, caused by even any contaminated area. Fourth, by using unclear syringes or the used ones. Now let's discuss about symptoms of smallpox. Usually after the infection of variola virus, the symptoms occur after 17 days. Below listed general symptoms are seen. Number 1, high fever followed with chills. Second, vomiting or nausea. Third, a severe headache followed by other body pains. Fourth, development of rashes filled with pus or fluid on the face, legs, hands, and etc. Origination of smallpox. It is believed that it is originated in Africa from a rodent that lived along the South Nile River in crescent green forests. The example of rodent are rats, beaver, guinea pig, squirrels, hamster, chimpanzee, field mouse, jerboa, and etc. From Africa, it then spread to China and India thousands of years ago. During the Egyptian Hittite War in 1350 BC was the first recorded epidemic of smallpox. Almost 2000 years later, this disease reached Europe, where it plagued the countries from 5th century to 19th century. From Europe, the disease spread to major cities all around the world, including the American colonies in the 17th and 18th centuries. Smallpox has played a major role in shaping the way Western civilization proposed and grew during the Middle Ages and into modern times. From the 10th to 18th century, smallpox accounted for more than 4 lakh deaths per year. The estimated death toll ranges from 300 to 500 millions of deaths. Now let's discuss about the treatment for smallpox. In 1980, this syndrome was declared as completely eradicated from the global immunization campaign led by the World Health Organization. With the help of the smallpox vaccine, it's the first infectious disease that has been eradicated from the world in 1990. The 1974 smallpox epidemic of India was one of the worst smallpox epidemics of the 20th century. Over 15,000 people contracted and died from smallpox between January and May 1974. Most of the deaths occurred in Indian states of Bihar, Odisha, and West Bengal. In this 5 months, India reported 61,482 cases of smallpox to WHO. India had over 86% of the world's smallpox cases in 1970. Primarily due to this pandemic, by January 1975, an operation was started aimed at containing the last cases of smallpox, called Target Zero. India eradicated smallpox in 1977. Saiban BB is the last case of smallpox in India. Before issuing no smallpox certificate to India, WHO sent 16 illustrious scientists and health experts from many countries to visit all the states of India and four of the Union territories for spot checking the veracity and dependability of the data gathered. The first effective vaccine to be discovered was smallpox vaccine, and it was developed in 1796 by Edward Jenner. Since it is a deadly disease, there is no such cure available for this syndrome. It could be still prevented by vaccinating with the smallpox vaccine. This vaccine helps in preventing the disease from illness and causing fatal conditions to the humans. The antibodies present in this vaccine protects the body from invading and to destroy the virus. So now our topic smallpox is over. Initially I said that we will also discuss about the chickenpox. So without doing time waste, let's begin about the chickenpox. The name of this hazardous disease is chickenpox or varicella. It is common childhood infection caused by the varicella zoster virus. It is most common in children and is usually mild. When adults get it, however, they get very sick. Chickenpox is dangerous for the people with immune system problems such as leukemia or the people who are taking drugs that weaken their immune system. It is communicable infectious viral disease characterized by itchy red blisters that appear all over the body. This dreadful disease was introduced the mid of 1990. It spreads in a similar way as the cold and flu infect. The incubation period is 10 to 21 days. The symptoms of chickenpox. Chickenpox often starts without the classic rash, with a fever of 101 to 102 degree Fahrenheit. So let's discuss about these symptoms. Classic rashes with fever, second headache, sore throat, stomach ache, stabs, nausea, tiredness, itchy skin, dehydration, muscle aches, mouth soreness, loss of appetite, fluid-filled blisters, difficulties in breathing. The viral infection can be easily prevented by vaccinating the newborn kids with chickenpox vaccine. This vaccine is 99% effective treatment that prevents the infectious disease infants by strengthening their immune system. Now let's discuss about the sources by which this chickenpox spreads. Number 1. Through pregnant women. Pregnant women are no different, and they can even develop the severe chickenpox. If you are trying to conceive and have not got chickenpox yet, then ask your doctor about the same and get yourself vaccinated. 2. A baby born to the mother who had chickenpox. 3. A patient with leukemia. 4. Anyone with immune system problems. 5. It spread from person to person through direct contact, like coronavirus. 6. It can also be spread to you through the air if you are near someone with chickenpox who is coughing or sneezing. Chickenpox and use of neem in India. Taking bath in neem boiled water to ease itching or recovering from the chickenpox is popular belief without scientific evidence in India. Although it has no effect on the varicella, it has antiseptic and antibacterial effects. It can prevent secondary bacteria related to skin infections. Now another doubt that arises in our mind is, can you catch chickenpox again once you had it? In the most of the cases, getting chickenpox once means you will not get it again. This is called long-term immunity. However, in rare cases, a person gets it again. What can parents do to protect their children from the chickenpox? Number 1. The best way to protect their children from the chickenpox is to have them vaccinated against the chickenpox, which is the chickenpox vaccine. Number 2. If your child is not yet vaccinated and he comes in contact with another child who has chickenpox, he may still be protected if he is vaccinated now. Number 3. If one of your child has chickenpox, it will be probably spread to other members of the household who are not already. If someone else catches the infection, it will appear 2 or 3 weeks after the first. Number 4. If your child has an immune system disorder, contact with your doctor. Now, last but not the least, pox party. Outside the India, people even have pox party where they invite other kids to their house if their child has got chickenpox. The whole purpose behind this is to make their other kids immune to the disease while they are still young. The kids share food, which increases their chances of getting the disease.